So I've had some weird dreams of late, but I'm not sure that any of them are prophetic or anything, although they could be. One of my friends pointed out that some of the dreams I've been having may be prophetic, and I just haven't inquired that they may be prophetic and ask what they meant, so I'm probably going to try to do that. But I did have one small miracle today, and what it was that when I was cleaning out the coffee machine that we have, I had poured some hot water into it in the reservoir thinking, well, maybe that'll clean it out better. Long story short, the engine started whirring a bit, so I was like, uh-oh. So I put my hand on the coffee machine and I'm like, Lord, if it be in your will, please heal this coffee machine. And the engine went back to normal, of course. When I told my mom about it, she wasn't too happy, but you know, well, maybe I'm learning in all this that if I can't get the big miracles for right now, or what I consider the big miracles, at least appreciate the small miracles. Because I am still praying for that big miracle, you know, like maybe I'll discover another family member or that, you know, I'll be able to find one or anything. And maybe Herman Cain could be the one. I'm just kidding. I would never go for a man like Herman Cain. And even if he does divorce, of course, I was going to say that now that he might be divorced, you know, but anyway, in all seriousness, I would never go for someone like Herman Cain. And so he suspended his campaign today. Many are saying that he's going to step down. And at first, I was thinking to myself, man, that's biased. He's just suspending his campaign. He's not going to step down. Although Herman Cain probably should step down. We're probably going to hear that he's probably, unless he gets some marital counseling or something, he's probably going to get a divorce. And, well, we all know how when you do something like Herman Cain did, we unfortunately know how the end game usually works. There's usually a divorce, and she's probably going to get alimony. And, or maybe, you know, even though she is in her 60s, maybe she'll find some 60 or 70-year-old widower who's looking for a good woman, and then Herman Cain will realize who he had, and who knows? Anyway, well, there you go, and take care, and Shabbat Shalom. Oh, and, so it's the first Shabbat of Kislev as well, so, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Rishon Kislev, or Rosh Kislev, whatever.